Hey guys, it's Chris. From extremely rare comics to ancient coins, here are 9 lucky finds that made people rich. Number 9, the Royal One. In Australia, in a place called Lightning Ridge, a man named Bobby, who refused to give his last name, was out collecting rocks for his job. As he was sifting through them, he found himself looking at a very interesting-looking rock. Well, how so? Well, this one sparkled in a way that most rocks don't. So that made it very unique and very special. Liking the rock that he found, he took it home and kept it. Fast forward over a decade, Bobby got curious about the rock and decided to take it to a specialist. What the specialist revealed was that this wasn't an ordinary rock. It was an opal. What's more, it was black opal, which is very rare. Plus, the size of the rock was actually rather significant, as the rock was measured at 306 carats. So just the value of the stone as he had it was over $756,000. But the stone would later be polished and refined, and then it would be valued at $3 million. Well, how could it cost that much? Well, because of the rarity and the size. Jewelry designer Catherine Jetter noted this about the black opal. The last significant opal stone of this nature, Aurora Australis, was found in 1938, Jetter explains. The Aurora Australis was considered the most valuable Lightning Ridge black opal ever found at the time, weighing 180 carats. It was valued at $1 million Australian in 2005. As a side note, Lightning Ridge is apparently known for its findings of opals. So, time to get searching, guys. Number 8, Wall Vault of Coins. When you have some spare change, what do you do with it? Well, I guess you either put it in your wallet or put it in a jar or container for safekeeping. Or you can put it in a piggy bank if you feel the need to be nostalgic. For one family, though, they had an entirely different idea. They decided to put their spare change in the walls of their home. This occurred in Pennsylvania, in an abandoned house owned by a certain family. Some of their kids were playing in the house when they noticed some coins lying around. They didn't look like modern coins, so they took them back to their parents. Upon inspection, the parents realized that these coins weren't just old, they were rare. So they hired a man named Jeff, who owned a rare collectible store, to search the house and see what else he could find. Sure enough, there were coins lying around. Then he noticed a hole in the wall, one that seemed to be much different than a standard hole. Breaking it in so he could see more, he found a plethora of coins that had apparently been stored there by the people who lived there beforehand. These weren't just basic coins either. There were Liberty dimes, Morgan silver dollars, and more. If you added up the worth just on face value, it'd be around $8,500, which is already a great find. However, further inspection showed the rarity of the coins, some of which made the worth of the coins around $200,000. Number 7. St. Albans Coins. For modern-day treasure hunters, sometimes the easiest and best way to go and look for rare finds is to just go and buy yourself a metal detector. It's worked for many people over the years, and that includes a man named Wesley Carrington. Wesley was from England and decided one day that he should go and get himself a metal detector. On his very first attempt to find something, he went to the forest near St. Albans. As he did, his detector went off, and as he dug, he found a gold coin, and then another, and then another, and so on and so forth until he found himself looking at 55 gold coins. But not just any gold coins, Roman gold coins, which were not only historically significant, but also very valuable. The coins were bought by the British Museum's Portable Antiquities Scheme for nearly $150,000. But that's not the end of the story. For after digging further, an archaeological team found 104 more coins, thus making it one of the largest hoards of gold coins ever found in England. And all because Wesley got a metal detector. And now for number 6, but if you're new here, well, hello and welcome. Have you ever found anything amazing just by accident? Let us know in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe before you leave and click the notification bell so you don't miss out on the latest videos. Number 6, the Hoxton Hoard. In 1992, a man named Peter Watling had a problem in his farm in Hoxton, Suffolk, in England. Mainly, he lost his hammer and truly couldn't find it. So he brought his friend Eric Laws and a metal detector and began to search the nearby field for his hammer. And as they did, the metal detector went off multiple times. And as they dug, they didn't find the hammer, but they did find silver and gold and lots of it. Some of it was coins, some of it was silverware like spoons, and some of it was gold and silver jewelry. Knowing what to do, they alerted the proper authorities who helped examine the area and found even more of these rare items, all of which were later dated back to the Roman Empire. Upon appraisal, the massive hoard of gold and silver that they found was valued at around 1.7 million pounds. That's $2.2 million, give or take. Since Laws found it, as it was his metal detector, the government of England offered to pay him the sum. Instead, he chose to split it with Watling. This noble gesture actually led to a change in the laws of England on this matter, allowing people to legally split the money of findings such as these. The items themselves, now called the Hoxton Hoard, are the largest collection of Roman gold and silver ever found in Great Britain. Number 5. Post-it notes. While discoveries of rare items are common tales of people getting rich, the option also applies to inventors who stumble upon their inventions that will make them legendary, such as Spencer Silver and the creation of the Post-it notes. It's hard to imagine modern life without the Post-it note, but back in 1973, it was just an idea of Silver's. And not the idea you might think. All he wanted to do was make a special kind of tape that would work on paper, likely without hurting the paper like most tapes do. Arthur Fry, one of Spencer's employees, actually had the idea to make what would be called Post-it notes, as he wanted to make a special bookmark via paper that people could stick anywhere. Combining the two ideas, Post-it notes were born, an invention that is so popular, 6 billion of them are sold every single year. Number 4. Action Comics Number 1. A couple were in dire straits. They didn't have enough money to pay the bank for their home, and thus, they were gonna lose it. As they were cleaning out the attic, they came across some boxes that they didn't realize were there. They began to search them and see what was inside, and when they did, they found something they didn't expect, a comic book. But not just any comic book, Action Comics Number 1. And what's so special about this comic? Well, it's the first comic to ever feature Superman. So the comic was from the literal golden age of comics. For the record, because of no one knowing the legacy that Superman would have, few kept their copies. Action Comics is actually still going today and has passed 1,000 issues. And as such, only 100 or so well-kept copies are said to be around today. The condition of the one they found was top-notch, and because of that, they were able to sell it for around $1.5 million, saving their home and their lives, all thanks to Superman. Number 3. Whale Vomit. The title may sound disgusting, but it's actually true in regards to what we're talking about, mainly that the projectile from certain whales is actually a very valuable item. The scientific name for this is ambergris. What it is the vomit that sperm whales spit up while in the ocean. Because it's lighter than water, it actually floats up to the surface. Then, being exposed to the sunlight, as well as mixing with the salt water, it creates a hardened material that is actually very valuable. Well, as weird as it sounds, this new substance is actually used in perfume creation. It can be used to enhance the smell of the perfume to make it last a lot longer. Due to this very valuable trait, the ambergris is actually highly valued. A single gram of the substance is worth $20. So imagine the joy that one Leon Wright had when he found a 14.75 kilogram mound of ambergris off the coast of Australia. Well, he sold it for $63,000. Number 2. The $2 million penny. Robert Lawrence was the son of a proud worker of the U.S. Mint in Denver, Colorado. However, when his dad died, he packed up all his belongings and took them to San Francisco with him. One of the things that his father left behind was a coin collection. At first, Lawrence actually forgot about the collection. And then a month after the move, he found it again and decided to take it to a coin expert. As the expert examined the coins, he found a rare 1974 penny, one that wasn't made of copper. Because of this, the value of the coin was set at $300. But then the expert did a little more digging, and what he found was shocking. This penny was actually made of aluminum, pure aluminum. This was only done to 10 pennies, and all 10 were thought to have been lost. It turns out Lawrence's father had somehow gotten his hands on one, likely the only one in existence, and because of this fact, the penny, which is only worth 1 cent, became valued at $2 million. Number 1. The Declaration of Independence. To be clear, a person didn't find the original Declaration of Independence. That's safely locked away in Washington, D.C. However, there were copies of the original made in 1776, and one person found one of them in a very roundabout way. This happened in 1989, and in Pennsylvania, no less, a man was at a flea market of all things when he saw a picture frame that caught his eye. He purchased the frame for $4. When he took it home, he removed the picture that the frame had in it already. And when he did, he found himself looking at a mint condition copy of the Declaration of Independence. Historical records note that only 25 copies were ever made back in 1776. So for this one to have survived this long makes it a true national treasure. Sure enough, after getting it authenticated, he sold it for $2.1 million. Then in 2000, someone sold it again, this time getting $8.1 million. Thanks for watching. Can you believe these lucky discoveries that people made? Which one is the most shocking to you? Let me know in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.